So here we are. We're ready for Vanessa C. Today is the consciousness through calendaring, setting priorities and boundaries. Open your heart and your mind and your soul for Vanessa. Give her a big smiles and applauses and love.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. What an events committee. I'm a sucker for Bruno Mars, so that music is great. It's great to see everyone, see your faces. It's always a shock to me how easy it is to meet with people from all over the world. It's great. I am honored and humbled to have the opportunity to share this tool from my life, and I hope it's of use. So, just to say a little bit about myself, I'm Vanessa C. I'm in Los Angeles. I've been in CoDA since the 4th of July, 2018, so I just turned 2 years old in CoDA years. I've known about my codependency for much longer than that, of course, but it's really been a blessing to me to be part of CoDA. And I first presented this workshop last month at our regional conference. So I'm happy to be here again. One thing I love about this tool is that it's really about consciousness. When I am extra codependent, it can become a little bit about control, but it really is helping me to move towards consciousness. And that's really the theme of this workshop. So it's a very simple tool. And I'm just going to start by sharing my own experience, strength, and hope with it, and then showing you the tool, which is very simple. But in my life and in the last workshop I gave, has proven to bring up an opportunity to create connection and trust with my inner child and with my higher power. And then we're going to have a generous amount of time to play with the tool and then debrief it as well. Along those lines, I just wanted to mention that this tool, you know, it really may bring up some emotions. When I gave this workshop last month, some people felt a lot of relief. Other people felt some resistance. And it's just a great opportunity to connect with myself, my higher power, like I said. So just to kind of get the ball rolling and get that sort of connection started, we're going to do a quick breakout group. We're going to put 4 people in each breakout group. And to get the juices flowing, I'm going to put a few questions in the chat box right now. And I would recommend maybe copying these questions out of the chat box so that you have them in breakout rooms. The questions are, what do you want to get out of this workshop? What feels like your calendar may bring insanity to you? Like, why are you here at this workshop? And then what kind of feelings are coming up for you on the topic of consciousness through calendaring? So Jackie, if we can go into breakout rooms with 4 people each, and let's do, since there's 4 in each room, let's do 8 minutes. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about my experience, strength, and hope now, and the tool itself. So I am definitely along the lines of a sort of A-type personality, so that's kind of part of the context that this is coming out of. I'm also a working person who has a lot of activities outside of work, so my time is pretty scarce, so I use the tool in that context. Some of the things that I'll be sharing with you may be very specific to me, but I think this is a tool that can really be adapted to anyone. I've adapted it to my own life and it continues to change and morph. Because resistance may come up, resentments may come up, this is particularly the case for me if a calendar is only obligatory item. If it only shows me things that I absolutely have to do and makes demands on my time, then I get grumpy and I'm not so happy to be using a calendar. When I feel resistance, it tends to be because I don't have enough fun and rest in my calendar, and I start to resent my calendar. So I've been learning this over the past, 10 or 12 years that I've been developing this tool. And I have to say, it's really helped me with increasing my serenity. My background includes extreme anxiety. I was like clinically diagnosed with OCD. So like I have a lot of anxiety in my past, but that's no longer the case. And this has been part of that journey for me and really bringing down the level of anxiety and having a better sense of my life. I've found that as I'm reading through the patterns of codependence, I think this tool for me really relates to the one that says codependents have trouble setting healthy priorities and boundaries. That's in the Green Workbook, page 50, in the list of patterns and characteristics of codependency. And so for me, it's really about developing consciousness of my priorities and of my boundaries. So I would like to review the tool itself now. So if the slide could come up with the tool, that would be great. Perfect. I'm sorry. So this is my tool. It's super basic, like I was saying. I set aside an hour every week to do this. The first thing that I do is I simply pray and meditate. I give myself 5 minutes. I set a timer. I turn down the noise in the background and find a comfortable place. And it's a combination of prayer and meditation. In that prayer and meditation time, I often think a bit about my last week. Lately, I've been thinking about how my higher power has actually rearranged my last week, and that in that rearranging, things were better than I anticipated. I didn't die. Things moved and I was okay. And so I find some like connection with my higher power in thinking about the last week. And sometimes I'll pray about the upcoming week and what might be on my mind, what I might be scared of, different things. And then I often will just sit quietly for a few minutes too, or if I don't have any particular prayer, I'll just sit quietly. My next step is to do a brain dump. So what I mean by this is I will get out a piece of paper, either a physical piece of paper or a blank Word document on my computer, and I will just dump out of my brain everything that's on my brain that I need to do in the coming week, every little thing from going grocery shopping to sending a happy birthday letter to my best friend to taking my pets to the vet, every little thing, just getting it out of my brain. Because once it's out of my brain, I find that I'm able to think a little bit more clearly about the week ahead. So I put that on the paper and then I set that aside for a moment. Then I think about what are the things I really need to be intentional about right now. So for me, with COVID, my gym closed down. It's still closed down and it happens to be near where I work and I'm not willing to, you know, it's a far distance, it's not open anyway. So I need to be sure I get my workouts in because they really help me with my sanity. It's just kind of who I am. I love moving, I love movement, I work a desk job, so I need to move as well. So I make sure I have 3 workouts somewhere on my calendar. And then because I'm desperate for recovery, I make sure I have 3 CoDA meetings on my calendar. I've heard it said that 1 meeting is tourism, 2 meetings is maintenance, and 3 meetings is recovery. When I first heard that, I thought it was crazy. I'm like, how can I go to 3 meetings a week? You've got to be kidding me. Last winter, I had a breakup, and I saw lots of old patterns in myself that were concerning for me. And I realized I was only going to 2 meetings. So, hey, maybe I'll try 3. And sure enough, it has been a big help. So that saying has been true in my life. And I'm deeply in recovery. I'm in my 4th and 5th step right now. So it is a priority to me to get to 3 CoDA meetings a week. The next thing I do is just look at my calendar. So I use Google Calendars. And I switch it over to a week-long view. There's some options there. I know different people probably use different ways of calendaring, so I'll just speak for myself. And I just look through the week. I look at every single item on my calendar. I think to myself, do I still want to go to this thing? Do I have to go to this thing? do I need to do preparation for this thing? So for example, today I'm giving a workshop. So I made sure earlier in this week to schedule time to meet with the committee to talk about it. And I made sure I had time to prepare for it. And I actually put that on my calendar because I didn't want to show up to this workshop in a panic and unprepared. And I know that about myself. So I just made sure to put it on the calendar. I look for double bookings. I go through it every single item on my calendar, just very like with a lot of consciousness in mind. Having done that, I review what are my priorities. So every year, usually in the winter, I look at what my priorities are for the year, and I pick usually three or four. And after I go through my calendar, I open up that document and I say to myself, am I actually making progress around these priorities in my life? And if there's something that doesn't line up at all with those priorities, then I remove it from my calendar. And sometimes that means I have to say no to somebody. Sometimes that means I don't get to do something fun, but that doesn't make sense for my life. What it does mean is I have more time. It does mean I probably get to go take a walk in my neighborhood. I probably get to connect with someone I really want to connect with because I'm making time for those priorities. And then I make, so that's kind of the focus piece. And I also like to identify one big goal for the week. And I just like to have that in my mind. So for this week, for example, I knew I needed to prepare for this workshop. So that was my one big goal for the week. So those are some things I do to try to keep focus in my week. And then I am very intentional about scheduling rest and play. My inner child has made it abundantly clear to me that rest and play are important to her. And when there's not rest and play, no one's having a good time. So I delete things from the calendar wherever possible. I actually schedule some downtime. So usually on like Thursday night from 8:30 to 10, there is nothing on there. There's a big block on my calendar that just says rest. And that way my inner child is not only interacting with the calendar as a thing that has to be done, but my inner child looks at the calendar and gets to go, oh, we get to go for a bike ride Friday night after work. I'm so looking forward to that. So that's an important part of my process too. After I've done that, I just pause again and I set my timer for 2 minutes and I pray and meditate again. It's usually just meditating on this one. And I just ask my higher power how I can surrender myself to my higher power's will. And if there's anything that I've done on my calendar that maybe I should change or edit or delete. And I just leave that space. And then after this, I usually review my finances. I use the Mint application online and I review my finances and my budget. And that's just an added piece of serenity for me to have a handle on that. So I'm not going to really go into that in this session at all, but that's part of my weekly process. So that's my tool. I'm going to tell you a bit about the learning curves that have come from this tool for me. I've mentioned this already a bit, but really listening to my own resistance and building communication and trust with my inner child. Like I mentioned, she's really helped me to understand that I need space for rest and play. For example, sometimes I mistakenly put something on a Friday night. I work Monday to Friday, 8:30 to 5-ish. Sometimes I will put like, I don't know, figure out my mortgage on a Friday night. And let me tell you, my inner child has zero interest in that activity on a Friday night. It does not go well. But I have learned that if I take myself out to play beach volleyball, or go on a hike for several hours on a Sunday, my inner child is more than happy to sit down with me on a Sunday night and let me take care of my mortgage stuff while she is just like passed out and happy from her day of having fun. So I've really come to understand that better about myself, and not trying to just push through resistance in myself, but work with the resistance to understand what the resistance might be. I've also learned about bringing my higher power into my schedule. CoDA's really helped me with this. I just told you, I will schedule my whole week. And one person could look at that and say, oh my gosh, this looks terrible. This looks like a straitjacket. This looks like a robot, you know, just like working through these things all week long. But the way that I interact with it is, I have a sense of what's coming in the week. And if something's on my calendar, it can move. If my higher power decides something different on a particular day, I know what the trade-offs are. So for example, someone died about a week ago in my life. Not someone I knew personally, but that really, really meant a lot to me. And it was extraordinarily painful for me. I had a really full day. I did not see how there was going to be time to grieve this person in my life. But looking at my calendar, I saw, oh, I have a couple hours set aside to look for a new apartment. You know what? I can do that the next day, or I can do that 3 days from now. I'm going to switch that out on my calendar, and I'm going to cry. I'm going to journal. I'm going to cry. I'm going to call some friends. I found that sort of interaction with my calendar has made a lot more space for my higher power. It's just very clear to me what the trade-offs are using this practice. I can really say, you know, I have to do this now. Like, there is a pipe bursting. I have to do this now. What has to move? And then I'm not getting anxious about, oh my gosh, like, what am I supposed to be doing that I'm not doing? I'm not aware of it. Ah! But instead it's like, oh, okay, I'm supposed to be scheduling my week. I can move that to tomorrow. That's okay. It also helps me understand what are my trade-offs in terms of, let me rephrase that. It also helps me to understand what I need to say yes and what I need to say no to. So like I mentioned earlier, it becomes very clear to me when I'm double booked, I can't do two things at once. And if I'm double booked with a friend, I'm going to have to say no to somebody. And I think that has just really helped me in my recovery, learning to be honest about who I am and what I can manage, and really admitting my humanity. I'm one person. I have 7 times 24 hours in a week. I can't be everything to everyone. And there are things in my life that are priorities. And that means I'm going to have to say no to some folks, or no to some events, or no to some tasks. And that's just been like a very humbling and grounding thing for me, learning to say no. But then on the flip side, I get to say, yes, I'm going to ride my bike to the beach on Friday with this great friend of mine. So that's been really cool. And I think just overall, it's really given me an awareness of myself and my patterns. It's helped me to see how I use my time. It's helped me to see the consequences of how I behave, which I forget exactly how it's worded, but I believe that's one of the things on the patterns and characteristics of codependence is not paying attention to the consequences. I've seen that in my life more clearly, and it really helps me to attend to the really important things in life too. I'm going to stop talking for a while, and we're going to go. I'm going to ask for everyone to go back in breakout groups. I'm putting some questions in the chat right now, and the prompts for the breakout
group.
Jackie, can you send everyone back into the same breakout room?
What's striking?
And let's do.
What's maybe missing?
Let's do.
And how are you feeling?
Give everyone 2 minutes to share. All right. In particular, the question about overwhelm, I'm just going to answer that super briefly right now, and we can get into more conversation about that during the Q&A at the end. What we're going to do next is actually have individual time to use the tool, and I hope that may answer some folks' more specific questions, just that activity itself. In terms of overwhelm, my experience has been that when I set aside the hour to do my calendaring prep every weekend, and I'm realistic with myself, that the overwhelm decreases because
then I'm starting to learn where I need to bring in help, where I need to say no, where I need to focus, those sorts of things. So that's my very quick answer. I just also want to acknowledge that that's just my experience, and perhaps other people in this room have other experiences, and perhaps we could share those together during the Q&A. So that's just my quick response to some to that one question in particular that came up. Linda, can we get the slides back up, please? Thank you. And the one that has the grid on it, please. Perfect. Okay, so this is the time to really dig into this. I would recommend either using an electronic calendar or a pencil if you're using paper rather than pen. I personally use Google calendars, like I mentioned earlier. If you don't have a calendar, there's this template. It's very easy. I'm sure anyone could do it on a piece of paper or computer pretty easily. And as we're going along, I have found for myself that when I think about a handful of questions, I get a lot more clarity about myself and about my own unmanageability. So just asking myself or noticing how my inner child is responding, and if I'm experiencing relief or resistance or something else in this process. So those have been helpful questions for me to be asking myself as I go along in this process. Next slide. Thanks, Linda. So I'm actually gonna encourage folks to take a picture of this with your phone, and I'll stop talking for a second so folks can do that.
We can also post this to our AZ website as a PDF. So if you can email that to me, we can get that uploaded. Your handout.
I have it.
Great, thanks.
Thanks.
You can also take a screenshot on your computer.
Yes, as well. Yep. I just wanted to be sure that folks have the opportunity to capture it now so everyone has it in breakout rooms. So this is the worksheet. We're going to spend the next, let me double check the timing on this. There will be 15 minutes for folks to work through this as individuals, just private time to work through this on your own. And then there'll be 10 minutes to discuss a set of questions that I'll put up in a second. So just to walk through it really quick, it's basically parallel to the tool I put up earlier, but with a few prompts to be helpful along the way. So the first action is to pray and meditate about your upcoming week. 5 minutes might be too much in the workshop format. That's what I do personally, but maybe a minute or two for the workshop format. Then that brain dump, just getting all the stuff out of your mind, that piece. And then thinking about what must happen every week. Being really honest about what's required and what's not. Is there a doctor appointment? You got to work this week, and putting that on the calendar if it's not already there. And then thinking about, what do you need in order to not just survive, but to thrive? Is it taking a walk after work? Is it laughing with your partner? Whatever it is, put it on the calendar. And then just to step back and review the week as it stands. Is there double booking? Is there too much? Are there things to say no to? Are there things that need prep added to them? Work it out. Work it out on that calendar. Use that pencil to erase things or add things. And then doing that kind of check. What are the top priorities in your life right now? Are they really showing up on your calendar? And then going back to your brain dump and seeing what among that brain dump is really essential to get in this week. There may be things that can wait. There may be things that don't actually need to get done. But what's essential for this week? And then doing another prayer and meditation. So this usually takes me 45 minutes. I'm I'm suggesting that we take 15 minutes, so it'll have to be an abbreviated version. And then to kind of process this, I'm going to drop some questions in the chat again. And these will be questions for discussion within your group. So they should be in your chat box. So how was it to intentionally schedule your week? Are there any feelings that came up in the process? How are they related to the patterns and characteristics of codependency? Do you have any questions, comments, or curiosities? And then how might you individualize this for your life? What do you need to add or remove to make it work for you? This is what works for me. I'm sure there's additions and subtractions and changes that would make this even better for other folks.